water, the water from, you know, gaseous form is called as vapor. Then the next thing we need to know is vaporization or evaporation. This is one of the same. So this is a process where we can see the conversion of liquid molecules into the gaseous molecule. There will be the change in state from a liquid state to a gaseous state. If you talk about water, like water molecules from a liquid state to the gaseous state, then we have this condensation. This is the process wherein we can see the opposite process of vaporization. Here we can see from the gaseous, the conversion of molecules from the gaseous phase to the liquid phase. Liquid phase to gaseous phase. And this is gaseous phase to liquid phase. Okay. Now we will come to vapor pressure. So I'm going to explain the vapor pressure using two scenarios. In the first case, we are supposed to take a container filled with water, okay, and provide heat. Remember, in the first case, it is open. It is open to the atmosphere. It is not closed. So when we provide heat, the water molecules here get this heat energy. Due to the increase of temperature, these water molecules get heat energy and they just start move in a random direction with different speeds or varying speeds. So each molecules have different speeds. So it's not same. This might have high speed or this might have low speed. Here they possess some energy due to the increase in temperature. This energy is specifically called as kinetic energy. Some of the molecules have high kinetic energy, some of the molecules have an average, and some of them have very low. So the molecules with high kinetic energy are able to overcome the intermolecular force very fast. So there is between the water molecules, this is a water molecule. We have some forces between another water molecule. We have some forces and interaction. So the molecules with high kinetic energy will able to overcome the intermolecular force and try to escape to the atmosphere. They try to escape to the atmosphere or space. Hence, here is the process of vaporization takes place, wherein it is converting from a liquid phase to gaseous phase. We can see the process of vaporization. So, since these are molecules in these are vapors which is going in up atmospheric direction, so they exert some pressure. So, vapors produce some pressure. So when this pressure is equal to the atmospheric pressure, we call it as boiling point. We call it as boiling point. This atmospheric pressure has many units to be expressed, such as atmospheric Hg, mm, and we have different. We generally talk about one atmosphere. Or if it is in Hg, it will be 760 Hg, or in mm, it will be 760 mm. So you understood the first case wherein it will be open to the space and the molecules get evaporated to the space. Understood, right? So we are going to talk about the second case. Here the topic of equilibrium come, like where the vapor pressure has an equilibrium, the pressure exerted at a equilibrium, no? That we're going to talk about in case 2. So here you take a container filled with water and you provide heat, but the condition is it should be closed. You close it from a lid. So when you provide heat, the same process takes place. The water molecules gain heat energy due to increase in temperature. This heat energy is specifically kinetic energy, and the molecules with high kinetic energy will evaporate first. And molecules with low kinetic energy will be a little bit late. So, but instead of going to the atmosphere, they get caught inside the container. They get sticked to here, like to the container. So, as the process of evaporation takes place, which is nothing but vaporization, they continuously take place. But at some point, some of these molecules get increased. All these vapor molecules get increased at a particular point. So they tend to go back to the liquid surface. The liquid surface which is present here, they tend to strike it to this. This vapors which has been evaporated and get caught inside the lid, they tend to go back to the liquid surface. Here is the process of condensation takes place. Okay. So after a point, the rate of condensation will be more and the rate of evaporation will be less. So initially what was there, in an initial stage, there was evaporation, rate of evaporation was high. And rate of condensation was low. And there will be an intermediate stage. Where rate of condensation will be high, wherein this molecule striking back to the liquid surface, that is condensation, where rate of condensation is high and rate of evaporation is low. Then comes the equilibrium state. Here it is kind of saturated, where rate of evaporation is equal to rate of condensation. So this particular stage we call as equilibrium state. So this is a state, and the pressure exerted by the vapors at this stage is termed as vapor pressure. Understood? You guys have any doubts until this part, vapor pressure part? Now we'll talk about the distillation. Process which we learnt now will take place, then condensation takes place. At last we are going to get the purified form of water, of what we are trying to get. So it's basic, there will be no chemical reaction taking place in distillation, it's only a physical separation process. We have types of distillation, I'll read it out. simple distillation, fractional distillation, steam distillation, vacuum distillation, air sensitive vacuum distillation, short path distillation, zone distillation. We are not going to study in deep, we will just study about the general distillation process. I am here going to do the distillation of water. How do we get the distilled water? So, you are supposed to take a flask. Filled with a normal water which has minerals, salt and everything. A normal tap water you take. You write it here. And you heat it. Provide the heat. It should be closed. But there should be a temperature thermometer. So, the heat is being provided there. And here in this part it is connected to a condenser which has an outlet and an inlet. So you heat the water, the normal tap water, only the pure water is able to vaporize at its boiling point. All the inorganic solutes or non-volatile solutes, non-volatile are the ones who cannot get vaporized easily. So all the inorganic materials will be here, but the water, the pure water gets vaporized. As I explained earlier, it vaporizes in the same way. At here at the exact point, it is again trapped by the condenser. It produces steam here, which is nothing but vapor. Steam is another word. Here the steam is being caught by the condenser, and here you can see the chilling and cooling of the pure water takes place. Here the water again converts from the gaseous form to liquid form. So in this condenser, there will be inlet and outlet which maintains the cooling effect, which helps it to efficiently coolify, and there will be conversion of from gas to liquid, and hence that is nothing but the pure water which is being collected here. And we have the application of vapor pressure. If vapor pressure, we wouldn't understand the topic and the concept of vapor pressure, we wouldn't have understand this distillation process, because the things here and here are going on is nothing but vapor pressure. You guys understood? Okay. So there are some of the applications of distillation. It is used to purify alcohol. In alcohol, the preparation industry, we have certain, one of the procedures we use is distillation to purify. Then we have desalination process. Desalination is nothing but where you remove salt from the salt water. And you crude oil refining, making of liquefied gaseous from air. Whatever the contents in the air we have is in the gaseous form. In order to liquefy back into the liquid state, we use the distillation process. Okay? You guys have any doubt?
Even in the